Please take your seats quickly, ladies and gentlemen. Thank
Hi guys, welcome to 1MinuteTennis.com. In today's session, I want to talk to you about rhythm and consistency, because I believe that rhythm and consistency are intrinsically linked. When you have rhythm, you play consistent tennis. When you don't have rhythm, well, it's going to be pretty inconsistent. But I want to show you how to get rhythm and what to do when it doesn't naturally occur in your game. Now, everybody's going to have good days when they play. Everything seems easy. It seems that they're just tuned in on the ball. But unfortunately, if we have good days, we're also going to have bad days. Days where the racket seems like almost a foreign object in your hand. Everything seems late, rushed, you're crowded, the ball's too close to you, and you've lost the timing, you've lost the rhythm. So what do we do to get that rhythm back? Now, my suggestion is that when it goes wrong, that you think about dancing the dance of the ball. You see, rhythm's quite hard to define. I mean, what does it actually mean? But when you apply it to music, rhythm is very easy to define. You get that person who's on the beat all the time, and you get the person, probably me, who's just off the beat or significantly off the beat. And you can see it straight away when somebody has rhythm with music. Now, in tennis, we don't have music, but we do have a ball. And this is what we need to find rhythm with. So what I suggest you do is that when your opponent hits the ball, okay, they're hitting the ball and they hit it and they lift it up over the net. As the ball crosses the net, if it's going to go in, it will always go down. So you move in line with the ball and then get a reasonably wide stance. And then as the ball goes down, in time with the ball, dancing the dance of the ball, you go down with the ball and then up with the ball. Okay, so you find your athletic position and then down with the ball and up with the ball. See here, down with the ball and up with the ball. If you go down with the ball and then up with the ball, a number of good things happen. First of all, your focus is on the ball. The second thing is that you'll be moving rhythmically in tune with that particular ball at that particular moment. See, when it all goes wrong, what a lot of people do is overthink. And when they overthink, it becomes very complicated. It needs to be automatic and yet in relation to that particular event. And so by going down with the ball and up with the ball, you'll find that you're dancing to the dance of the tennis ball. You're in rhythm and the bad days will disappear very quickly. It's a great piece of advice, but you only apply it on the days when you're struggling, when things seem very difficult and when it's all going wrong. And then once you're back in rhythm, try not to think about it. Just like when you're dancing, just go with the flow of the music. But this time, go with the flow of the ball. Let me know how this works for you or for the players that you're working with. You know we love your feedback and we always reply to every single comment. If you want to try this, then have a look at our partners, playyourcourt.com. They send professional tennis coaches direct to your area and to your local courts. It's a great service. The link to their membership is in the comments section below and there's a big discount off their membership if you use that link. And maybe I can help you more with your game. Have a look at what online coaching can do for you. It's a unique service and the information for that is on the website below. Hope you enjoyed today's session. Thanks for watching and see you next time for more unique tennis lessons that really work.